Thanks for the help, Mikey. Here you go. Oh, he said suck it up. Here you go, Mike McGrath.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. All
right, no, seriously, can we just fill up these, like, four seats up here? And my girlfriend probably come up. Dwayne, obviously Dwayne. You probably come up here. Joe, Kate, get the fuck down. You guys can stay. You made it. We still have two. My girlfriend's still back there. I'll go fuck myself. That's what you have to do when your girlfriend... Oh, thank you, Kyle. Kyle, that is great. Oh, okay, Em, I understand. Yeah, you're too late. You were too late. Yeah, I was late, too. Alright, so talking about my girlfriend, I believe in hit or miss relationships where I hit that and then miss their calls later. Okay. I just opened with that shit. Alright, so, on that topic, I was researching elephant penises lately, and, like, there's this thing, they actually started, like, circumcising elephants, which is weird, because I don't know why you'd have to, because I feel like, but I guess, like, the females have, like, this thing where they don't, like, flap, but, I'm sorry, that was stupid, but, okay, so, they circumcise elephants, right, and elephant circumcisions, there's an average 2 pounds of penis lost on elephant circumcision, which is disgusting, right? But it's like, that's a full 2 pounds of penis, and that's like two black dicks, or like six white ones, or like 12 Asian. Okay. Ah, man, like that's like a kindergarten like science class. Like, oh no, that's one black dick, Mrs. Robinson. I measured it out. That light is so bright. Alright, so I was recently thinking about how classic rock songs are really just rap songs in disguise. Like, you can change one word in, like, classic rock songs, and it'll change it to a rap song, and it's kind of like this. I'll give you a demonstration. But it's just like, bye, bye, Miss American Pie, bitch. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but that levee was dry. Me and my boys was drinking whiskey and rye, bitch. Till the day that we die, bitch. Till the day that we die, bitch. Okay, but, so, I'm doing a lot of things recently, and that has nothing to do with my next joke. My next joke essay has to do with my girlfriend, but oh, I was doing a lot of things, but okay, I brought that back. Okay, so me and my girlfriend, we went on a date the other night. We went out to Savona's downtown. Trent, you work there, but we went there, and it was like a good romantic night, and it's like, it's everything you have to do to get porked on like a daily basis from your loved one, and everyone knows my struggle, Tremper's girlfriend. But, like, my girlfriend, she always picks, like, these movies that are, like, kids' movies. And it's weird that, the reason it's weird is because we always do it, like, after we watch these kids' movies and or during, for, like, motivate. But we do these things, and, all right, so the movie she picked is Winnie the Pooh. And so I'm watching like this terrible Winnie the Pooh movie that I watched when I was 3, and I don't remember when I watched it, so it's all new to me. Still terrible. But we're like, alright, so it's like, I know that I'm gonna get it in by watching this movie. And her neck, and then like I move up to her ear, and then I know how to seal the deal because I'm a man and I have a wiener that works sometimes a lot. Oh, it's a thing. But like I whisper in her ear, the softest voice I have, I want to put my piglet in your Pooh Bear. And, I feel like she takes it the wrong way because I never get laid after late. I said that. Alright, but so do you guys want to know the nickname for my penis?
No? Yeah!
Alright. Too bad. But, no, it's the Indian Giver. It, Yeah. All right. I'm happy you guys enjoyed that. Having a lot of fun tonight. No, I'm kidding. We're not having that much fun.
Shut up.
I didn't want to tell him on mic because that's fucked up. But, all right, so I was thinking about how my dad never gave me, like, a talk as we were kids. Like, that talk about vaginas and what we have. And I always thought about, like, I'm going to give my son that talk. He's going to get that talk. And the best way I could think about it was, like, vagina, all right, son, three-year-old son, because that's when you, but, like, I always thought about it, like, as a, I'm like, it's like a Scantron test, which is the weirdest, like, comment, but it's like, you never have the answer key for a Scantron test, right? But the woman's head is the answer key, so you're never going to know. It's like, every question is a yes or no question, but it's actually not. It's a yes, no, or none of the above question, because that's how fucked girls are, but they get, but, ooh, Trent, but, and then the good thing, like, there's one good thing out of Scantron test, because, like, one wrong answer can ruin your life, no con, but, like, the only good thing about Scantron test is that they only accept number two pencils, and a number two pencil is, like, your penis, but that's, like, the good thing, it's, like, there's no penis that's too different because it has to be number two penis. And the good thing about number two pencils is that, like, no matter how much your mom tells you, the more you sharpen it, it's going to go away. It'll never go away. It's going to be there. It's small. My name is Mike McGrath, guys. Have a good night. Yeah!
Thanks, Mike. Mike, I just want to let you know.